Now, as we've mentioned several times throughout our kickoff, our event today is being graciously hosted on the campus of North Central College in Naperville, Illinois.
North Central College is home to over 60 academic majors, including engineering and computer science. To offer an official welcome to North Central College, I'm honored to introduce Dr. Frank Harwath, Director of the Engineering Program and Chairperson of the Department of Mechanical and Engineering. Dr. Harwath has over 30 years of experience in product and process development. He holds 95 patents for a range of products used in computers, graphics hardware, and sporting goods. Everyone here today, please give a warm first welcome to Dr. Frank Harwath.
Thank you very much. I'm hoping everybody can hear me. I want to also extend my own personal welcome to all of you today. We really appreciate the FIRST programs, all of them, but we especially like FIRST Tech. We think that it is a very realistic environment for people that are interested in engineering to learn from, and it gives you a wide range of experiences that go beyond just the classroom. We like FIRST so much that we offer special scholarships for any of you that participate in FIRST that decide to come here for engineering. Am I not doing this right? Bear with me. Could I get some tech help here? Because it seems to be on. So, a slight delay. Looking back to our tech team over there, can you index the slides for me? Awesome. Thank you. So the first thing I want to address is the state of the college today. I'm hoping that all of you get a chance to see the college. Okay, fantastic. Thank you. I hope you get a chance to walk around the campus today, and I hope that some of you are able to stay for the tour of the new lab after the conclusion of the other events here. North Central College is growing, and is growing in diversity, and growing in terms of the number of programs that are being offered. So engineering's fairly new. We're in our fifth year of instruction. We just had our first graduates last May. And it's growing very, very well. We couldn't be more pleased. Our students are already getting jobs at companies like Honda Motors, IBM, Fermilab, Navistar, Northrop Grumman, Harding, a whole bunch of very, very top-of-the-line companies are hiring our graduates right now. And we have a number of students that are also at those same companies for internships, including during the school year. So this is a fantastic program. It's a great way to learn engineering and to have job opportunities upon graduation. So obviously we were affected by COVID-19. You might be wondering, where are we at right now? And basically we're getting back to normal. This is the first time that we've run this event since 2019. So you can imagine, we've kind of missed you, and we really are happy to have you back on campus. A number of things are changing, and they're changing every day in terms of having contact with the students. And again, it's based upon how you feel. It's a mask optional environment. We do expect everybody basically to get their vaccinations and so forth. But basically, if you're covered and you feel comfortable, you don't have to change your behavior at all when you're here, which is fantastic. And by the way, it's really good for engineering from the point of view that it's hard to run a lab by a simulation. you really have to get your hands on. And that's another thing that we like about FIRST, is the fact that you're getting hands-on experience. You're learning what happens when things go wrong. You're having to figure out how to fix things. And that is essentially the life of an engineer. So you're really getting some good experience. Another thing that's happening is that we kind of had a hiatus on a lot of our club activities for the last couple of years, and that's really coming back. Some of you that were in my seminars this morning heard about the fact that we're starting up our SAE team to build a Formula SAE racing car. It's going to be electric. We're very excited about that. We're starting a chapter of the Society of Women Engineers this year, and we're also starting another chapter of the American Society of Mechanical Engineers. And our biggest club right now is the Society of Hispanic Professional Engineers. Now, a question that I get a lot, and if you're serious enough about an engineering school, I'm sure this is something that comes to mind, and it's going to be mentioned by a lot of the other schools out there, is that they say, make sure that you go to an ABET accredited school. I have answered this question literally hundreds of times. The program was designed to be ABET accredited from the very beginning, well before we ever admitted any students. The thing is that the ABET as an organization will not accredit your programs until you actually run the program completely, have graduates, and then they come by and do an audit of your program. And that's exactly where we are at right now. We're going to be audited by ABET this month in a couple of weeks, and that will essentially be our application to be accredited by ABET. And we should find out within a few months whether or not we passed. I put a note in there. ABET doesn't make it a practice of denying accreditation. As you can see that last year, and these are the numbers that I got at the National Convention of ABET this last spring, is that 245 out of 246 programs that were evaluated by ABET last year were approved and accredited. So we feel pretty confident that we're going to be accredited by this time next year. So I really like this slide because we have some new faculty. What you see going from left to right there is Dr. Shanju Chang. She's an assistant professor of mechanical engineering. She does a lot of work with control systems and simulations and things like that. In the center there is Dr. Hector Rico Aniles. He is assistant professor of electrical engineering, and he's working on a lot of really interesting research, especially an open source teaching robot that you might be interested in working on. And then the gentleman on the far right there is Dr. Irfanal Alam, and he is an assistant professor of mechanical engineering as well. He specializes in robotics and manufacturing processes. And his research is extraordinarily interesting because he works on things like micro robots, you know, the kind that are about insect size, and he uses high-speed cameras to watch their behavior and so forth. So he does some really, really interesting research. So this slide kind of gives you an idea of what our students are like. This is the slide from last year. I don't have the current data. But basically, we are at around 145 students in the engineering programs right now, distributed amongst the computer, electrical, and mechanical disciplines. What's interesting is that roughly half of the students coming here are first gen. In other words, nobody else in their family has been a graduate of a four-year program before. And that a number of our students fall into a number of different diverse groups, as well as Latino, African American, and women. And actually, the number of women is going up significantly because Dr. Chang came 2 years ago. And since she's been here, the number of women applying to the program has gone up significantly. So we really like that trend. This gives you an idea how we're performing based upon our models for attendance, you know, and people coming to the college. You can see the upper and lower bounds, and we're kind of splitting the difference between the two, but we're doing very, very well in terms of attracting and keeping students here. In fact, our retention rate for most of the years that we've been running the program has been running very much above the national average. One of the great advantages of North Central partially is where we're located. We're in an area where there's a tremendous amount of activity that requires engineering jobs. The Naperville-Aurora area especially has a number of national and international companies with a large number of engineers present at their locations. In fact, I've had people from the schools that are more closer to the lake, like IIT and Northwestern. People I know there are very envious of us because we're much closer to these different industry organizations than they are. Downtown, you tend to get legal organizations and bankers and things like that. This is where the engineers get jobs. Our Office of Career Development supports and runs job fairs every year. We have one coming up at the end of September, and this is another great thing. Companies are coming here every year, more and more companies, to meet our students, interview them, and to offer them internships. Another advantage of coming to North Central is that we have a very close partnership with the Illinois Institute of Technology. Illinois Institute of Technology wants our graduates so much that they offer them a special accelerated pathway through their master's degree programs. If you come here and you major in engineering, you're allowed to basically pre-enroll into this program through IIT, and you can take courses while you're here as a North Central student that will count towards your graduate degree as well as your undergraduate degree. So you only pay for it once and you get basically credit for it twice. You can take enough courses that it takes off an entire semester of study from your time to get your master's degree, so it reduces the amount of time. So now time and expense is reduced. Once you graduate, IIT will bring you on board as an IIT student and give you a $17,500 scholarship, which will pay for a huge portion of your master's degree. So literally, you can go through North Central, get your bachelor's degree in 4 years, and finish up your master's in one, if that's your desire. Now, you don't have to do that. IIT lets you take up to 6 years to complete your master's degree, and that scholarship is prorated and basically used as you take the courses. So, really good thing. We have a number of students enrolled in this already. Another great thing about North Central is the fact that we have study abroad for engineers, which is basically unheard of. This is not something that I had as an option when I went through as an undergrad. So our first school that we're set up with is the University of Limerick in Ireland. It's in Shannon, and it's a wonderful university. It has a long, very prestigious technical background, and we set up our curriculum so that no matter what kind of engineering you take, basically in the second semester of your junior year, you can go and study abroad for an entire semester. And the cost is extremely low. In other words, all the costs that you normally spend to go to North Central or transfer to there, the additional costs that it takes you to study abroad are pretty minimal. So it's something that if you're interested in a study abroad experience, that I highly recommend. The thing that I'd like to add as well is that a number of the companies that are on our industry advisory board are international companies, and they really, really like to hire people that have had international experience. There's just something that happens to people when they have to work and live overseas that they develop a sensitivity to other cultures, and they develop a much better understanding of how to interface with people and work with people in a global setting. And that's really helpful if you're an engineer. All my jobs for the last, oh my goodness, before coming here for the last 30 years, I was working on teams, international teams, and you really have to understand personal dynamics in an international setting to be successful. Another thing that happens here, this is not in any way competitive to First Tech Challenge, but we are also very supportive of Project Lead the Way. You may or may not be involved in that. You may or may not be familiar with it, but it's a pre-engineering program at many of the schools around here. We ran an event last April, which was a design competition. It went great. I think we had about 400 people attend that one. That's another thing that we like to support here at North Central College. By the way, the trophy that you see there, the kind of fancy, you know, engraved Lucite wood trophy, was made in our manufacturing lab. And it was everything there that you see, other than gluing it up, was done by lasers. So it was all done with a CO2 laser. I can show you that this afternoon, but we have, you know, various other lasers that you can do this type of stuff. So just to give you a sample of what can be done. Another thing that we're now instituting as a standard part of our school year is we have the engineering capstone, which is a class that basically is the culmination of your experience as an engineering student. Pretty much you get to do an independent project doing most anything you want. There are constraints in terms of time and funding and so forth, but pretty much you can do what you want. We had a student make a pitching machine. We had another student do a can crusher. We had another student do, a team work on an automatic guided vehicle. There's just a huge number of different things that were done by students in the capstone. And then they did a poster competition, which is very much like a typical research competition, and awards were given to the students for that competition. And this gives you an idea of some of the things that were produced. The student that's standing there is standing in front of a 1,000-watt fiber laser, and what he's holding in his hands are actually spur gears that were made on that laser. And it literally took seconds to make these gears out of quarter-inch thick steel. The lower left picture is a ducted fan analysis of fluid dynamics that were used in a hovercraft. Upper right there is part of that automatic guided vehicle that I mentioned. It was done by mechanical engineers because they were designing the drive systems and the lifting mechanism, because this automatic guided vehicle has to be able to raise 300 pounds and to haul it around the lab, and that's actually working quite well. And then the thing that looks like a scooter is a scooter, and unlike most scooters, you can fold it and to make it a smaller size. This is just showing some of our staff. You can see some of the professors that I showed you earlier. They attended the first robotics regional competition here last spring. We typically go to a number of different competitions, including FTC competitions, and we host FTC competitions when we can. Another activity we get involved in, we have a robotics club on campus, and we participated in the competition, the BattleBots competition at UIUC last spring. And Mario, where did we place? I thought we placed second in that. I think he left. So anyway, he's very competitive. He does a very good job on that. So, this is a little bit of a busy slide, but what that does is give you an idea of how many labs we've built for the engineering programs in the last 5 years. We've built two electronics labs, the Harding Lab and the Molex Advanced Electronics Lab. We built the Omron Design and Automation Lab. We built the Metrology Lab, the Computer Applications Lab, and the Manufacturing Processes Lab. And that's what I'll be conducting tours of after the conclusion of the activities here today. Just to give you an idea of the size of this lab, if you were in any of the seminars this morning, those rooms are typically about 600 square feet. The Manufacturing Processes Labs is 6,000 square feet. And it has all the latest technology that you could ever want for making parts. And it has a full-time lab supervisor. So this is what it looked like a year ago. You can see it was mostly just an empty space. Oh, should probably put another slide in between there. I apologize. Oh, I didn't have another slide. Anyway, you know, let me go back to this one. This is just an example of one of the talks that we had during the year. So we have monthly talks by leaders in the industry. This was when Dr. Wang from Nanograph, their battery materials supplier for lithium-ion batteries. They develop chemistries for the high-performance batteries. And he had a talk with us, I think, last April. And then the thing I wanted to mention, too, is scholarships. I had already mentioned earlier that we give special scholarships for people who participate in FIRST. If you have participated at least 1 year in either FTC or FIRST Robotics, we will grant you a $2,500 a year scholarship for attending the engineering programs here at North Central. So basically, it's a $10,000 windfall for you by participating in FIRST if you come here as an engineering student. In addition to that, and the reason it's on the top there, is that Navistar recently gave us the largest gift ever for the engineering program, and most of it's going to scholarships, and they're being used right away. So they instituted the Emerging Leaders in Engineering Scholarship. They consider them the students that participate in this to be their students. They're part of Navistar, if you will. So you can imagine when these students basically apply for internships and jobs, they're probably going to get some really nice treatment from Navistar. And Navistar set up this scholarship for students that come from underserved communities and also for women. So that's what they're trying to do, is to get more and more engineers to have a better representation from all diverse groups. We also have the Dainty SCAG Science and Engineering Scholarship. This is wonderful because this has actually been here at North Central for a number of years. But what's happened is that over the last couple of years, about half of all the scholarships are going to engineering students. The rest of them are going to chemistry and physics and all the other STEM disciplines. And then also, the Dunham Foundation has been wonderful. If you're not familiar with the Dunham Foundation, they do fantastic work. Mainly with educators in the Aurora area, but they have graciously offered a number of scholarships for our students in engineering. And these students are staying in the Aurora area in order to basically give back to the community that's been supportive. And that is the conclusion of my presentation, but what I'd like to do is offer to answer questions. We have microphones on either side of the stage. If there's anything that anybody would like to ask, I mentioned this in the seminars this morning. I worked for 36 years in a variety of engineering roles in a number of different international companies. I started companies, so I've got a lot of engineering background. I can give some insight as far as that goes. Or if there's things specific to the engineering programs here at North Central, I'd be very, very happy to answer any questions. Don't be shy. Do you have a question? No? We offer computer, electrical, and mechanical engineering. Now, each of these can morph into a lot of different things. So I have people come to me and they say, I'm interested in biomedical. And I go, okay, you realize that biomedical could be your specializing computer, you know, in software, or you could specialize in electronics, or you could be a mechanical, you know, mainly mechanical. I think it's better if you're interested in biomedical to get a basic engineering degree first, like, for example, mechanical, and then get a master's in biomedical. I think that's a better pathway. Yes, sir. Yes. Oh, that's a really good question. So we are considering branching out into other schools in other regions. So Tsinghua in, I think, Taipei is probably the next place that we're looking at. We are looking at Birmingham, the University of Birmingham in England. We're also working in North Africa. So that's kind of where we're headed. Oh, I do want to bring up, Australia didn't work out. They came to, no, I'm serious. They came to us and they said, we'd really like to do it. But the problem was the way they do their schedule, their winter is our summer and so forth, it just didn't work out. We couldn't have students go there at the time they needed to go there. More questions? Okay, well, thank you very much. We very much appreciate you coming here today.